few seconds only. After that, I'll start my session. With the permission of you guys, I'm going to record the meeting. I hope you guys have permitted me to record the meeting. It is going to get recorded. So in today's session, we are going to talk about an overview of GST, how the GST is introduced and what were the reasons behind, recording is started now. I can start the session. And in this particular session, I'm going to share you one PPT also. And through that PPT, I'm going to talk about how the GST is important and what sort of things we are going to learn under the subject, which is made as a special subject, that is IGST. So what is GST, what is IGST, what is CGST, what is SGST? So many things we are going to cover in this particular topic. Even we are going to talk about our topic number one, and that topic number one we are discussing today. So before going to start, let me please allow me to share my screen so that I can share my screen. Now you tell me whether my screen is visible or not. Is my screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so today, if you don't get my voice, if you don't, if I get disconnected in between, please let me know by calling me on my number so that I can understand. Otherwise, I'll keep talking and I don't realize that I have been disconnected. So today we are going to talk about the introductory part of our subject, which is called as IGST. The full form of IGST is Integrated Goods and Services Tax, which is our special subject. As we know that in 2017, Government of India, that is Modi government, has enforced one particular new act which was related to indirect taxes, and that was none other than GST. The full form of GST is Goods and Services Tax. So in this particular session, we are going to talk about this particular one and how it has been enforced, what were the reasons behind the enforcement of GST, and we are going to talk about one more things, that is what sort of things were there before the introduction of GST, and what were the reasons behind introducing or enforcing GST in India. And before that also, how many countries were there, those who used to go for GST before India. So many things we are going to discuss, and the title that I have given for this particular lecture is Goods and Services Tax, an Overview. So we are going to take the we are going to understand the background, we are going to understand each and every aspect which was related to Goods and Services Tax. So this is the point of discussion today. So friends, I welcome back you all for the session. And in this particular session, the topic is what? Goods and Services Tax, an Overview. So how it was important, and so many things we are going to discuss here. So before going to discuss, let me ask you some question. When this Goods and Services Tax was introduced, do you have any idea what sort of tax is this, whether it is a direct tax or indirect tax? Answer my questions, please. What do you think? This Goods and Services Tax is a what type of tax, whether it is a direct tax or indirect tax? Come on, you guys have to interactive between my sessions. Remember, you guys have to answer my questions. Come on, what do you mean by indirect tax or direct tax? And tell me, GST comes under which category of tax, direct or indirect? Come on, don't waste my time.
It's an indirect tax, sir.
Okay, very good answer. Who is he?
I'm Snehal Patil, sir.
Okay. So whatever answer given by this brilliant girl is correct. And this Goods and Services Tax we can consider under the category of indirect taxes. As we know that there are two types of taxes that we have with us in India. And those two types of taxes are direct taxes and indirect taxes. When we get back to the types of taxes, direct, what does it mean? Indirect, what does it mean? That also we are going to see. And already we have seen those types of taxes in TYBCOM auditing and taxation. There is no need to revise. But at the outset, I know that you guys have forgotten everything that you guys have learned in TYBCOM, because as it was online, and we know the drawbacks of online. Still, we are conducting online because of certain limitations. And whenever government will issue certain guidelines regarding offline, we will call you for the offline lectures without fail. So this one is a just sort of information regarding offline. So as he said, these goods and services taxes are indirect taxes, no doubt. And here we can understand there are two types of taxes that we come across, and those two types of taxes are direct taxes and indirect taxes. So direct means what? The burden of taxes directly on the taxpayers. When the burden of taxes is directly on the taxpayer, it is called as direct taxes. And when it comes to indirect taxes, if we want to understand the concept of indirect taxes, the burden of this kind of indirect taxes is not directly on the taxpayer. Somebody has to pay on behalf of the taxpayer, but the direct tax is not paid by the taxpayer directly. So this is what it is called as indirect taxes. Suppose if I'm going to pay the indirect taxes, I do not pay that amount of indirect taxes which is applicable to me directly to the government or directly to the taxation authority. I pay indirectly on my behalf, somebody will pay that amount of taxes, and this is what it is called as indirect taxes. When it comes to direct, as I told you just now, direct taxes are directly paid by the taxpayer. For example, there are certain examples of direct taxes. One example I will give you, because that is very much familiar with us, and you guys have seen that kind of things in TYBCOM. So sort of example is here with me, and that is income tax. Income tax, suppose I'm getting income, suppose I'm earning income, so I will pay the tax to the government. So there is no person who is going to pay on my behalf. I have to pay the taxes to the government. So when it is happened, it is called what? Direct and indirect. So this one is just a part of a reference information for you all. Once you complete your detailed diploma and somebody asks you what is direct and indirect, and if you are not able to answer, so that will be the tragedy for you guys and for we also, as a as you are a student of our college. So they will ask you where you have studied, and then definitely you will say that I have studied from PC College Baramati. So when somebody asks you what is direct, then you guys have to say that the burden of tax is directly on the taxpayer, and taxpayer will pay the taxes. When somebody asks you about indirect taxes, then you guys have to answer like this: indirect taxes are not paid by the taxpayers directly. Taxpayer pays those taxes indirectly, and on behalf of taxpayer, somebody will pay that amount to the government, and it is called what? Indirect taxes. I hope you guys have understood the concept of direct and indirect in a thorough manner. If not, please tell me. Otherwise, I'll go for one more time. If it is clear, then I can go for the next one. And the topic which we are discussing, that is goods and services tax. So till the 1st July, means till 30th of June, means 30th of June 2017, we had all those indirect taxes. Can you name those taxes which we had before 1st July 2017? So before the introduction of GST, we had different types of indirect taxes in India. And those were varied according to the states also. The number was also huge. And after the introduction of GST, there is only one tax. And this is what GST is called as one tax, one nation, or one nation, one tax. So my question is what? As you guys are having a bachelor degree in commerce, so you might have aware with this particular one. Before the introduction of goods and services taxes in India, what were the indirect taxes? And those are abolished, which are replaced by GST. Come on. What were the indirect taxes that we had before the introduction of GST? Any idea? Come on. You guys have to answer. Come on. Hello, are you there in the meeting or not? You all are there in the meeting, but you're not answering. My question is what? What were the indirect taxes before the introduction of GST, which we had? Can I talk in Marathi in between?
Sir, that's our...
Hello?
Sir?
Yeah, please.
Service tax.
Come on, good. Which one was the first one that you said?
Somewhere else.
Okay. VAT. service tax. Somebody excise was talking duty. About yes, boys. Yes, please.
Excise duty.
Yes, correct.
Custom duty.
Excise is not. Nowadays, excise is there or not?
Entry tax, luxury tax.
Okay, good. Very nice answers are coming out. Very nice. Yes, man. Others are, you know, others are keeping mum. They also talk. Shall I talk in Marathi in between? If you want. Hello, answer the question. Say, I don't keep like this. Don't sit like this in the lecture. I like to talk with people in the class. And I want to make our session interactive. And if you do not interact, then what is the use of this one? This one is called as one-way traffic, one-way communication, one-sided affair. And I don't believe in one-sided, one-way traffic and, you know, if it is so. Come on. You can talk in Marathi also, no issue. Please talk in Marathi if you want to give your answers. So answers that I got as far as indirect taxes are concerned, we had goods service tax, we had VAT, value added tax, we had excise, we had custom. So many types of taxes were there, and those taxes are replaced by GST. Good example. So with this, we are going to see the overview of goods and service taxes in India, why it is implemented, why it has been enforced, what were the reasons, what were the taxes, and what were the countries, those who had already enforced this GST in their countries, their states, and so on. So this is the point of discussion today. Once again, I welcome you all for the first session of IGST. Actually, the topic, the subject which is given to us is integrated goods and service tax. But integrated goods and service tax is one of the components of goods and service tax. This is what just I'm giving an idea about goods and services tax. And at the same time, we will go for the next one. So come on now, we're going to see the contents now. See, these were the taxes that we had before the introduction of GST in India. As I told you, on 1st July 2017, I think 4 years are already gone. 4 years are already gone. And this one is done by Modi government in 2017, and bill was passed, and from 1st July 2017, this particular GST is introduced. Before the introduction of GST, we had certain taxes, and those are noted down here, and those taxes were called as indirect taxes. So what were they? As far as central levies are concerned, or central indirect taxes are concerned, we had custom duty, we had excise duty, we had service tax, and we had CST, central sales tax. So these were the taxes which were there under the control of central government. And this is what those called as central levies, means which are levied, which are charged by the, or which are controlled, managed and controlled by the central government. And under that, we had custom, we had excise, we had service, we had CST. Now, when it comes to state levies, which are managed and controlled by the state government, and under that, we had different types of taxes such as entry tax or octroi duty, entertainment tax that we pay for the purpose of entertainment. When we go to watch a movie, we pay entertainment tax. And because of entertainment tax, we used to pay more amount for the movie ticket. So then when it comes to another one, that is electricity duty, luxury tax, VAT. So these are the taxes which were there as indirect taxes, and those were under the control, under the, those were levied by the state government. Those which were managed by the government, state government, or which were controlled by the state government. As far as state governments are concerned, there were 5 types of taxes which were levied by the state government. And when it comes to central government or which are levied by the central government, there were 4. So these are the taxes which we had before the introduction of GST. And you guys have, I think, understanding the background behind the introduction of GST and you guys are going to understand what were the taxes we had before the introduction of GST as far as central government taxes or central government manage and control is concerned. When it comes to state government manage and control is concerned, we had five taxes that we guys have understood from this particular slide. Without fail, I hope you guys have understood this. Moving on to the next one, and there we are going to talk about these kind of things. And here what we are going to see, central and state taxes to be submerged in GST. Those who are merged, those who are absorbed by GST, those who are amalgamated in GST, those are taken here. When it comes to central taxes, as I told you, we had different types of centrally or central government controlled taxes, which are the part of GST now. So which are they? We are going to talk about those taxes first. It comes to, or it comes from, central excise duty. As you guys have seen, there was one duty which was controlled by the central government, and this is what it was called as central excise duty. Then additional duties of excise, then central sale tax, then SAD and CVD, then service tax, then surcharge and cesses. So these were the, cesses, we call it cess means adhibar. So these were the taxes which are merged, which are amalgamated, which are included in a simple term, if I want to tell you in a precise manner. So all these are the central government taxes which are included, merged, amalgamated, and in absorbed in the GST. So these are the taxes which are taken from the central government and merged into GST. When it comes to state taxes, so there were so many state taxes which were charged by the state government, and those are also the part of GST now. And which are then, what are they? State VAT oblique sales tax. Before the VAT, there was sales tax, so that was also merged. Then entertainment tax, not by local bodies. Then exempt ions. Then taxes on lottery and betting and gambling. Then luxury tax, entry tax, purchase tax, surcharge and seizure assesses. So all these state government taxes are also merged in GST. And nowadays we can say, GST is a one nation tax. Why it is called as one nation tax? Because all these kind of central indirect taxes and state indirect taxes are the part and parcel of GST. All those things are involved here. All those things are taken care. All those things are merged. All those things are amalgamated in GST. Remember, and this is what GST is called as one nation, one tax. Actually, this one was a practice of foreign countries before 10 years than India. As we know that in 2017, from 1st July 2017, GST is implemented, enforced in India. But India is not a first country who enforced GST first in the world. There were so many countries, they enforced GST before India. I think they enforced GST in 2002, 2003, 2005. There is a huge history of GST. This is what I can say. India is not a first country who enforced GST in our country. So this is the thing that we guys have seen as far as various types of taxes which we had before the introduction of GST, and how those are merged. As far as central taxes are concerned, there were so many taxes. As far as state governments are concerned, there were so many taxes which are merged. So this is the sort of merging, the tax merged in GST. And we are moving ahead and going to see what were the things which we wanted to see. If you look at this slide, you can understand something. And what is that? Major taxes remained post GST. What are the taxes which are remained on after the introduction of GST also. So what are they and which are they, which we are going to see? Just let me put this icon at the proper place so that you can see the content of this slide. So there are certain taxes which remain after the implementation of GST also. Come, please come in. Whatever it is, like such a lot. Okay. So these are the major taxes which are not involved, which are not the part of GST. So remember, as I told you, so many indirect taxes are merged in GST, but these are the taxes which are not merged in GST, and they are here with us. They are still in existence. Which are they and what are they? Just look at this. As far as central taxes are concerned, these are the taxes which are not the part of GST now. Still they are there. Central excise on, central excise duty is still there on certain things which is not merged with GST. Now the government is thinking about it to merge with GST. What are they? Central excise on tobacco products. Whatever tobacco products we see around us, I think tobacco products are banned in Maharashtra, but in certain states of India, those are not banned. So whatever taxes government, central government charge on those, that is central excise on tobacco products, petroleum products, still petrol is not under GST now. If it comes under GST, the price of petrol will be definitely lower than the other prices. And basic custom duty is also not merged with GST, remember. So three types of taxes as far as central taxes are concerned are not merged with GST, remember. There may be a question, if I go for MCQ, there may be a question on this particular slide. What is that? Central excise on tobacco products and central excise on petroleum products are not merged with GST. Even basic custom duty is also not merged with GST, remember. So these are central taxes. Moving on to the next one, and that is state taxes. What are the state taxes which are not merged, which are not included in state taxes? That is also we are going to see. As far as state taxes are concerned, certain state taxes are not merged in GST. Which are they? The first one is what? State excise on alcohol or liquor. You know the meaning of word alcohol or liquor. There is no need to explain the concept of alcohol or liquor. So whatever excise and state government used to charge on alcohol and liquor, still it is there. It is not merged with GST. And this one is alcohol or liquor is the most and important and the major source of revenue for the state government. And this is what, you know, you still remember the witness of this. When making things normal after COVID, we opened alcohol or liquor shops first. So this is the point, because that was the major source of revenue for the government. Then second one, that is state VAT on alcohol or liquor, petroleum. It is in the news on WhatsApp that how or why petrol is costly in Maharashtra or in India, because central government has given certain rights to the state government to charge excise according to their requirement on the petroleum products. And it varies. As we know that in Maharashtra, petrol is costly when we go to Goa, when we go to Karnataka, when we go to any other state. The petroleum prices are different. Somewhere it is cheap, somewhere it is costly. Why it is so? Because it is depend upon the excise duty that particular state government is charging on the petroleum products. Maharashtra government is charging more excise duty on the petroleum product, whereas Goa government is charging lesser amount of excise duty on petroleum products. And this is what we can see, these kind of variations. And if it comes under the category, under the regime of GST, then the prices will be common in every states of India. So this is what people are asking for, or people are demanding to get petroleum products under the regime of GST. But state government is opposing for this because they may lose their revenue. That is the reason. So forget about it. Just I'm telling you the examples which are not covered, which are not included in the GST. Then stamp duty that we pay at the time of buying any sort of property or selling property at the time of buying and selling a property. So stamp duty is also not covered under GST. We need to pay extra. Still, it is that. Electricity duty is also not covered. Profession tax we pay. Those who are working somewhere, they may understand. We also pay the amount of profession tax to the government apart from GST and all. We pay 2,500 per year to the government for the purpose of profession tax, as we are doing profession of teaching. So teaching is not a, you know, charitable activity. If teaching is considered as profession, so we, whatever we are doing here in this college or somewhere, whoever, those who are doing the role of teacher, they are doing their profession. So they have to pay the tax, which is called as profession tax. So that is also not covered under the state, under the GST, and excluded by the GST. Road tax, whenever we go to buy a vehicle, whether it is two-wheeler, four-wheeler or anything else, so we need to pay the road taxes at once. One-time tax or road taxes, that tax we pay. So if we pay road tax to the government, it is also not covered under the GST. Why they are not covered so many taxes under the GST, we also don't know. But it is the things which is still remain. Then taxes on mineral rights, so that is also not covered. When it comes to local body taxes, that is also not covered, that is also not included in the GST. What are they and which are they? Just we are trying to understand what are the examples. Local body taxes means what? Let me tell you the concept of local body. What do you mean by local body? For example, if we reside in Baramati, so in Baramati, local body is what? Municipal corporation. If we reside in Pune, then what is the local body? Municipal corporation. That is, we call it Nagar Parishad and Mahanagar Palika. If we reside at a village, so Gram Panchayat is a local body. So if we reside in a village, if we have a house in a village, so for that house purpose, we need to pay one certain amount of tax to the local body. We need to pay a certain amount of tax to the municipal corporation. We pay a certain amount of tax to the Nagar Parishad or municipal corporation, right? So see, whatever taxes we pay for the purpose of house, if we have one property, for example, house, so we need to pay tax to the government year by year or year to year. For example, that we call it in Marathi, gharpatti. So that tax is also there. It is not merged with the GST. So property tax is there, entertainment duty is there, Gram Panchayat taxes are there. In Gram Panchayat, they take a number of types of taxes. Panipatti getar, gharpatti getar, diva batticha paisa getar. So many types of taxes they take from us, and those taxes are remained. And those are not covered, those are not included, those are not merged, those are not absorbed in GST. So this is that I wanted to tell you through this particular one. I hope you guys have understood. If not, please let me know. Then we are going to talk about GST features. Now we are coming back to the GST now. And here we are going to talk about GST. As I told you, GST, the full form of GST is what? Goods and services tax. So goods and services tax, that they collect by using different components. As far as GST is concerned, let me tell you the background of GST. Actually, as I told you just now, GST is not the first, or India is not the first one who implemented or enforced GST in our country. There were so many countries, they started using GST in their country before the 20 years of India. And they were comfortable with the taxes, and this is what the Indian government also start thinking about it. In 2005, I still remember, Manmohan Singh government, put 1 billion to the parliament for the discussion purpose. And those days, I think BJP was in opposition. So they opposed for GST in 2005 or 2006. But in 2017, they only brought the bill into the parliament and they passed it with majority. And this way we started we implemented GST in India. So from 1st July 2017, the goods and services tax is enforced. And the logic behind the enforcement of this particular goods and services tax is what? It was based on consumption tax. Whatever consumption you are doing. See, basically we consume two things in our life, which are the goods as well as services. If we consume goods, then we need to pay the taxes. If we consume services, then we need to pay the taxes. So whatever we are consuming in the form of services, in the form of goods, then we need to pay the goods and services tax. That is the main fundamental. And this is what destination is, what? Based on consumption tax or based on consumption. So if you are buying, but your family members are consuming, still we have to pay. So consumption is the important one, and there are two types of consumption that we go for. One is goods, another one is services. So it is applicable for the entire nation, as I told you. It is applicable for all types of activities that we go for. And there are certain goods and services are also exempted from the GST and SGST. There are certain exemptions that also we are going to see in a detailed manner. And if we want to go for registration under the GST, there are certain limit which is called as threshold limit. Threshold limit for if you are doing the business, and there may be a question for you, as it is an indirect tax. And if you are doing a business, then you have to collect this tax from the customer, and on behalf of customer, you have to pay to the government, right? But when it is applicable for you guys to pay the taxes, that is called as threshold limit. And threshold limit varies according to the nature of business, according to the nature of registration also. That also we are going to see in a detailed manner. Dual GST having two concurrent components. As I told you, there are different types of GSTs which we are going to see in days to come. And this is what separate acts are made. There are basically four types of GSTs that we see GST. So there are four components of GST. For example, CGST, not for example, they are CGST, SGST, IGST, and UTGST. So let me tell you the meaning of what CGST, SGST, UTGST, and IGST. CGST means what? Central Goods and Services Tax. Then SGST means what? State Goods and Services Tax. And UTGST means what? Union Territory Goods and Services Tax. And the last one, which is the important one, that is IGST. And that is our subject, remember. And that is our subject. And what is that? I for integrated, G for goods, S for services, and T for tax. Integrated Goods and Services Tax, this is our subject. So basically, there are four components of GST: CGST, SGST, UTGST, and IGST. I hope you guys have understood. So these are the four types. And for these four different types of GST, separate acts are made. There is one act which is called as CGST or Central Goods and Services Tax Act 2017. State Goods and Services Tax Act 2017, Union Territory Goods and Services Tax Act 2017, Integrated Goods and Services Tax Act 2017. So these are the four acts which are made separately. And out of those, we are going to see one, that is Integrated Goods and Services Tax Act, in our syllabus. So this is the sort of background for GST that I have told you. And n number of things are there that we are going to see one by one. So for today, only this one is there for my end. Now I'm going to talk with you. I'm going to stop my presentation now, and I'll get back to the home screen. So, and there I'm going to ask you something. So, friends, today we have taken just a background, just and sort of introduction of GST. And here we have understood why this GST is introduced and what all the taxes that we had before the GST. Things, such kind of things we guys have discussed. I hope you guys have understood. And tomorrow also, we are having our session. And in that session, we are going to talk about next some things which are happened in GST. And when I complete this kind of overview of GST, then I'll get back to the IGST, and there we are going to see the actual contents of GST without fail. So This is the sort of delivery from my end. Now I would like to ask you some questions. If you want to ask some questions, you can ask me some questions, or else we can end our session here. Before going to end my session, I request you all to ask your questions in any language. There is no language barrier as such, but as the instruction medium or the medium of instruction of our course is English, this is what I prefer to talk in English. But if you want to ask your questions, you can ask your question in Marathi, Hindi or English, anything else. I know three languages and I'm comfortable with three languages. So similar sort of things are there with you also. If you want to ask, please, you are free to ask. You are allowed to ask. Come on. Come on, do it fast. If you want to ask, come on. And one more thing that I would like to tell you. Ask your friends that to join the sessions on time. Ask your friends to join the sessions on time, because we have already started and only we have 50% or lesser than 50% strength in the class right now. Okay, I'll do one thing. I'll stop recording. So this could not be the part of recording.